Welcome back to the MOOC course on corporate social responsibility. My name is Aradhana Malik and I'm helping you with this course. And we were discussing the categorization of the theories on corporate social responsibilities as proposed by Garriga and Melle. And we discussed the first two categories. Now we'll move on to the next two categories. So the last category that we discussed were the political theories. Now we'll talk about the integrity. The third category as proposed by Garriga and Melle is the integrative theories. The integrative theories consider that business ought to integrate social demands. And this particular category argues that business depends on society for its continuity and growth and even for the existence of business itself. So this theory is focused on the detection and scanning of and response to the social demands that achieve social legitimacy, greater social acceptance and prestige. And this theory says that we must find out what the society needs, we must integrate whatever the society needs into the strategy of the organization. And you'll say stakeholder theory. Stakeholder theory is related to the integrative theories. We'll move on, you know, from here. But this really says that we must take everything together, and this group says that the social needs need to be integrated with the expectations of the society need to be integrated with the strategy of the organization, with the way an organization functions. Now, this particular group is further categorized into four different groups, and these are: the first group is issues management, then the principle of public responsibility, stakeholder management, and corporate social performance. Let's see what each of these are. Issues management is the process by which the corporation can identify, evaluate, and respond to those social and political issues which may impact significantly upon it. So anything that is affecting the organization can be dealt with. And social responsiveness is an element of issues management, and social responsiveness deals with the action, the how of CSR. Okay, we are talking about the importance of CSR, we are talking about why CSR is important, we are talking about why, you know, we need to be responsible, but how do we do it? Where do we start? So this particular set of theories talks about specific things, and it says, okay, we identify the issues that are affecting the organization, that the organization is affected by, and then we deal with these issues. So for example, discrimination, that is again, you know, that is say or lesser say child labor is something that can be affecting the organization, and the organization needs to deal with it. So these kinds of things, these issues are important for the organization, and the organization just goes out and then starts dealing with these specific issues. One such issue is of Rugmark. I don't know if you know of the story of Rugmark. So I cannot take names of organizations here, but again, a very very well known supplier of home furnishings was accused of employing child labor without even having realized it. They would get vendors, and you know, vendors would have sub vendors, and so they would source their goods from specific areas. And what happened was, at some point journalists found out that the primary source or the place where these people were sourcing carpets from was employing children as labor. Now this particular organization had nothing to do with children, had nothing to do with child labor, but this was one issue that was specifically affecting this organization. So they decided to investigate it, they found out, then they decided to launch special activities. They would go all the way and find out who was making these carpets, and then they came up with the rug mark initiative, and the seal of rug mark meant that there no children had been involved in the manufacture of these carpets. If you want to know what this is about, you can always go online and find out the more about the rug mark initiative. So, so that is one specific issue that this organization was dealing with, and they went out and dealt with it through their socially responsible activities. So that is one very nice example of issues management. So they didn't just talk about helping people, they went out and did something about it because this particular issue had affected them. Then the principle of public responsibility. The second category here is the principle of public responsibility. Public policy includes not only the literal text of law and regulation, but also the broad pattern of social direction reflected in public opinion, emerging issues, formal legal requirements, excuse me, and enforcement or implementation practices. Public responsibility is something that, Preston and Post said we will not talk about social. We have already discussed this earlier also. They said we are not going to talk about social responsibility. Our responsibility is not to the society at large. Society includes a lot of things. We are talking specifically about the public. So it's a broad pattern of social direction reflected in public opinion. What do most of the people want? What are the emerging issues that are affecting the general people? And what are the implementation, formal legal requirements, and how can we implement these legal requirements, or how can we enforce practices that can then synergize with these legal requirements? So the scope of managerial responsibility in these theories pertains to there's a primary scope and there's a secondary scope. Primary scope is the essential task of the firm, such as locating and establishing its facilities, procuring suppliers, engaging employees, carrying out its production functions, and marketing products. Now, so whatever the firm does, that is the primary responsibility. Secondary scope of managerial responsibility involves things that come along. They are a consequence of the primary. For example, career and earning opportunities for some individuals, etc. So things that are not directly related to the firm as such, but come as a consequence of what the firm is doing. The principle of public responsibility says that law and the existing public policy processes are taken as a reference for social performance, and this group of theories deal with these are the theories that state that the law and existing public policy should be kept in mind while designing social activities, while going out into the society and doing something for the society. So we must be in accordance with the law, we must fulfill legal requirements, we must follow the general opinion, we must know what the public wants. This is related to stakeholder theory, but not really. So this is one group of theories that specifically deals with compliance, regulations, legal requirements, etc. Okay, then stakeholder management is the third group. Now, we have talked about stakeholders earlier, so I will not go too much into detail on this, but there are two principles. The goal of these theories is to integrate groups with a stake in the firm into managerial decision making. Now, the principles underpinning stakeholder management are, these were proposed by Emshoff and Freeman in 1978, and these principles are, the first principle says that the central goal is to achieve maximum overall cooperation between the entire system of stakeholder groups and the objectives of the corporation. The second one is, the most efficient strategies for managing stakeholder relations involve efforts which simultaneously deal with issues affecting multiple stakeholders. So these are the two principles, and the goal is to get the stakeholders here. The first goal is to get the entire system working together. When we talk about principles, the first principle is that all the stakeholders should be part of a system that functions smoothly. The second principle is that the efforts that we put into the system should simultaneously deal with issues affecting multiple stakeholders. How do we get these people to work together? We must do what they need from the organization. We must help them function smoothly. So this is what these two principles are all about. And the goal is that we get people with some decision-making authority to work together into the managerial decision-making. And this group of theories talks about this. The theories say that yes, the society, we are an important part, the profit-making organization is an important part of the society and is supported by the society. So the society itself is a stakeholder and we must get the voice of all that are involved. Now, corporate social performance is another group, and this particular group talks about the operationalization of CSR through principles of CSR expressed on institutional, organizational and individual levels. So we are talking about performance, we are talking about action, we are talking about integrative theories, and this is another group of integrative theories which talks about real action, nuts and bolts of what happens in CSR. So the operationalization according to these theories should take place through the knowledge of principles of CSR that are expressed on institutional, organizational and individual levels. The processes of corporate social responsiveness, action, what is the output, such as environmental assessment, stakeholder management and issues management, outcomes of corporate behavior including social impact, social programs and social policies. We need to see something tangible. It's not only talk, it's something tangible, something solid on the ground that people can see and feel and evaluate and experience. Okay. The last group of theories that Garriga and Melle talk about are the ethical theories, and they say that these are the theories that talk about the public good. These are the theories that talk about doing something because it is the right thing to do. These are the theories that say that the relationship between business and society is embedded with ethical values. We need to be good citizens, we need to be good people, we need to be good corporations, we need to follow ethical patterns of behavior. So there's an element of morality here. They also say that firms ought to accept social responsibility as an ethical obligation above any other consideration. Money is important, but not as important as doing something right for the welfare of the community that you live in. But you know, money is not ethical considerations achieve a higher priority, they assume a higher priority than everything else. So we must do what is right. Now in this group of theories also there are four different approaches. The first is normative stakeholder theory, then we have universal rights, we have sustainable development and we have the common good. Let's see what each of these are. Normative stakeholders theory says that the firm has a financial responsibility towards its stakeholders. The firm must make money, you must generate profits and you must share those profits with the stakeholders. So the stakeholders have a stake in the organization and they must be compensated through the profits that are made. The basis for the stakeholder theory is the stakeholders are persons or groups with legitimate interests in procedural and or substantive aspects of corporate activity. They are identified by their interests in the corporation, whether or not the corporation has any corresponding functional interest in them. The second one is the interests of all stakeholders are of intrinsic value, in that is each group of stakeholders merits consideration for its own sake and not merely because of its ability to further the interests of some other group such as the share owners. Every stakeholder is important. This group says that the normative stakeholder theory is say that every stakeholder is equally important, they must be given equal importance, they must be, you know, the firm has a financial responsibility towards all equal equitable financial responsibility towards all of its stakeholders. And when we talk about stakeholders, stakeholders are people who are genuinely, they are legitimately connected to the organization, because of which they should be treated as such by the organization. The second group here is that of universal rights, and this particular group of theories deals with the universal rights of the community, and this is based on the Universal Declaration of Human Rights adopted by the UN General Assembly in 1948 and other international declarations of human rights, labor rights and environmental protection. So universal rights are you know, this group of theory says that every, you know, the environment should not be polluted, animals should not be killed, you know, all children have an equal right to education. It's, of course, I mean, all of these are very valid points, and they say that these are universal rights that all human beings have, and they must be taken into account while designing any socially responsible activities. So all organizations have a commit or have a an obligation to protecting the universal human rights or the universal rights of the community they function in. That is what this group of theories deals with. So these particular theories talk about these things. Then sustainable development is another group. So there is one group of theories that focuses exclusively on the integration of social, environmental and economic considerations to make balanced judgments for the long term. We are talking about sustainability. We are talking about doing things that will not only maintain the status quo but keep it running. What is sustainability? Sustainability is that if we have something, some process, operation in place, some resource in place, we must not deplete it. If we cannot add to it, at least the status quo must be maintained. We must give back as much as we take. So you cut down trees, you go and plant the equal number somewhere else so that the overall volume remains the same. So we are talking about sustainable, that's a very crude example of sustainable development, but we are talking about sustaining our resources. We are talking about creating a balance between our use of resources and the replenishment of resources. That is sustainable development. And if I get into a discussion on sustainability, that will be, you know, that will be totally out of the scope of this particular series of lectures. So you can go and see, view the lectures on strategic communication for sustainable development for more inputs on what sustainable development is. But we are talking about maintaining a balance between use of resources and replenishment of the resources that we use. And these theories talk about sustainable development as part of the ethical theories. We have a responsibility and obligation towards replenishing the volume of resources we use so that these resources are there for others who want to use them. Everybody, if everybody does this, then the cycle will continue. Okay. The last approach here is the common good approach. And the common good approach says that business, as with any other social group or individual in society, has to contribute to the common good because it is part of the society. We must do whatever is good for the community that we are in. Business should neither be harmful nor a parasite on society, but purely a positive contributor to the well-being of the society. So that is what this group of theories says, that we must keep on doing something nice for the community. We must not harm it. We must add something positive to the society that we function in. Now, these are the four approaches. Let me show you a summary of these four approaches right here. I've pulled up the paper here, and this is the paper that I showed you earlier. This is the paper titled Corporate Social Responsibility. I'll show you the paper here. It will be easier. Can you please focus on this, on the screen, on the paper in my hand? Thank you. So this is the paper, Corporate Social Responsibility Theories, Mapping the Territory. Maybe I have it pulled up here also. Let me show it to you. Yeah. Okay, this is the paper. Let me just increase the size. Very, very nice paper if you can get a hold of it. The authors are Garriga and Elizabeth Garriga and Dominic Melle, and it's been published in the Journal of Business Ethics, Volume 53, Number 1 and 2. And this is the same paper, but I have turned the table around. So this table, what this table does is, this table summarizes what I've told you in the past two lectures, in the previous lecture and this lecture. Okay, here. So the, say, maximization of shareholder value. Instrumental theories focus on achieving economic objectives through social activities. Maximization of shareholder value was dealt with by Friedman and Jensen. Strategies for comparative advantages were dealt with by Porter and Kramer, Hart, List, Prehlad and Hammond, Hart and Christensen. Prehlad, again, cause-related marketing talks about altruistic activities socially recognized as a an instrument of marketing, and this was dealt with by Varadarajan and Menon, etc. So, you know, you can see this. I don't know if you're able to see all this. Okay, right here. So some references are given here. So different theories, we can have an extended discussion on theories, but that will be totally out of the scope of this course, so I will not delve too much into it, but I will give you these references after obtaining permission from the authors, and then maybe you can go through these on your own. Various the theories proposed by all of these people have been presented here. So you know, so there is enough going on in the world about corporate social responsibility. People are talking on different levels. People are talking about various things. People are talking about approaching or giving back to the society in different ways, and what all of these things are mushrooming up, and you will know more about this when we discuss the history or evolution of CSR in the upcoming lectures, and you'll see how interesting this has got, and how these, you know, these theories have developed and all that, and how these efforts have come to be what they are today. So various types of things are coming up as we are talking, as we are presenting this lecture. More and more insights would be coming up in the area of CSR. More and more inputs would be there. You know, people would be categorizing, people would be coming up with newer ideas on how to help the society. So this really sums up our discussion on the theories of CSR, and we will be moving on to different topics in the upcoming lectures. Thank you very much for listening. Thanks.